Hello everyone and welcome to Services Classes. So in this video again we'll continue our discussion with the test of mathematics question. So again we'll be discussing three different types of questions pertaining to different subjects or different components of the mathematics under this paper. So with that said, let's try and start off with the first question. Let I equal to root under minus 1. Then which of the following options are true? That is, I and minus 1 each have exactly one square root. I has two square root, but minus I doesn't have any. Neither I or minus I has any square root, or I and minus I has exactly two square roots. So let z square equal to I equal to cos n by 2 plus I sine n by 2. Okay, I'm represent the same in a trigonometric form. And also I n by 2. Okay. So therefore, this can be further written as z equal to plus minus e to the power I n by 4 equal to plus minus cos n by 4 plus I into sine n by 4. Okay. Which can be further written as plus minus 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2 into I. This clear? So similarly, minus I has exactly 2 square roots. Square roots is plus minus e to the power minus I 3n by 4 equal to, let me write it here, equal to plus minus cos 3n by 4 plus I into sine 3n by 4 equal to plus minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by root 2 into I. Okay, so what we have is that I and minus y each has exactly two square roots. So it can be seen that therefore option D is correct. So I and minus y, we have exactly two square roots. So I hope this is clear. Now with that said, let's move on to the second question. So let's take a look. If complex number WZ represent two diagonally opposite vertices of a square, then the other two vertices are given by. Okay, so let's take a look. So diagonally opposite vertices of a square. Let's try and draw the coordinate axis at first. Okay, say this is our coordinate axis. So let there be a square. Okay. So now if we try and name the square itself, say say this point be x1, y1, say this be x2, y1, this be x2, y2, and this be x1, y2. Okay. All the coordinates of the point. Now, if we say, if we simply say, suppose this is a square, say. So, let me say what is given, complex number W and Z represent two diagonals. So, if I just say that this diagonal, let this be two diagonally opposite vertices. Let this be W and this particular vertex, this one and this one, let them be W and Z. So one thing we can actually see that whatever kind of the representation of the same, the diagonal of the both the vertices or both the vertices of the square, they always are similarly identical. So let's take a look at the option itself. Yes, they'll be on the opposite coordinate axis and their coordinates will be different, but on and on their pattern will, they'll be, the length of the same will actually be the same, and subsequently their representation will also be more or less identical. Let's take a look at the options W plus IZ and W minus YZ. Okay, so this won't be the case because the coordinates will be of equal length and of opposite dimensions. So this option gets cancelled out. Half W plus IZ plus half W minus IZ, and the half W plus Z and W half minus IZ. No, these are no similarity. We won't, this particular terms, there's an issue with the same, so this will also be wrong. Half W minus Z plus half W, half into W minus Z. Okay, so the negative, so negative and negative, so entire terms are taken as negative, so that will also not be the case. So finally, by the process of elimination, if you take a look, half W plus Z, and the first the real part is taken, and again the imaginary part is taken, again subsequently real part and the imaginary part. So yes, this is the correct, because both the diagonals will be similar. And here we can see in this case just in opposite transponents. So this is the correct answer. So I hope this is clear to you. Now, with that said, let's move to the next question. So let's take a look at the third question. Let A be the element of A plus B root under 1 minus 1. So it's the third question. So let's take a look. Let A be the element of A, B root under minus 1. A, B are integers, and U is the set where X is the element of A, and 1 by X is also element of A. Then the number of element is what we need to find. So let's take a look. Suppose A equal to 0, B equal to 1, and A equal to 0 and B equal to minus 1. So what I mean by this is I and minus I, they both belong to U. Okay. Further, I can write A equal to 1, B equal to 0. That is 1 belongs to U. Okay. Again, A equal to minus 1 for B equal to 0, which would further mean that minus 1 also belongs to U. So therefore, how many elements do we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So with that said, since we have 4 elements, so this is our answer. So I hope this is clear to you, the kind of approach we have taken towards solving the same. So with that said, we have come to the end of our video. We have discussed 3 important questions over here. So hopefully all these questions are clear to you pertaining to the approaches we have taken towards solving the same. So kindly go through the entire video as many times as you like, so that you can get a clear understanding of all the concepts that we have discussed pertaining to solving the same. So more or less all the questions were about complex numbers in general. So kindly go through each and every day and try to solve the question on your own with the video as a reference, so that you can get a clear understanding of the same as well. So if you like the video, then make sure you like, share and subscribe to our channel, so that we can keep coming up with the relevant content such as this further down the line as well. And you can go check our further playlist as well on the following topics, so that you can get to know and get to practice a lot more questions pertaining to the same kind that we have already discussed in the prior videos as well. So with that said, I hope all the things pertaining to whatever we have discussed and all the different types of questions or the 3 questions that we have discussed in this video are clear to you. And if not, kindly make sure you go through the video as many times as you are comfortable, so you can get a clear understanding of the same. And again, I will one more time lay emphasis on trying to solving the same with your on your own with the videos that I've done. So with that said, I'm signing out. Thank you so much.